Today we are out here at Spring Lake in Santa Rosa enjoying the early morning. It's a beautiful place. Come with us, take a look.
Hey, yeah, speaking of looking, up, up and away. Hi, I'm Michael.
And I'm Grace.
And together we are California Travel Videos.
Have you been to California, seen the sights and people there? Walked the streets of sleepy sea towns, tasted salty ocean air.
Reason number one, location. 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 Spring Lake Regional Park is a 320-acre public park in southeastern Santa Rosa. That's in Sonoma County, California. Back in 1962, the lake was originally created as a flood control reservoir and a precious water supply for the Santa Rosa area. Now, 9 years later, in 1973, construction for the recreational facilities followed. As us outdoor types currently are faced with gas prices soaring higher than these birds, well, we appreciate that not much can beat our nearby beauty. And for us California types, numero uno is our nearby lakes. In the case of Spring Lake, it was a pleasant surprise for us to discover this gem in our own local backyard 30 minutes from home. So our appetite to focus on more local getaway treasures has piqued our interest, and we wholeheartedly recommend that you capitalize on the beauties near your home turf too. Okay, stay tuned and we will show you some of the reasons that Spring Lake gets well over 1 million visitors a year.
Reason number two, camping. If you want to stay a little longer, the park has 31 campsites that are set amid a beautiful oak woodland that sits just above the lake. Tents, trailers, and RV campers are all welcome. Each of the sites have a fire pit and a picnic table. However, there isn't any water or electrical hookups. A dump station is available for registered guests. In 2022, the overnight fees are between $35 and $37, depending on the season. There are also three sleeping cabins available with rates between $79 and $99 per night, depending on the size. Each cabin features sleeping platforms with mattresses, decks with seating, porches, a picnic table and a prep table, fire ring, charcoal grill, and even a food locker. But be sure to bring your own bedding and your own lighting and maybe just your own food too. Sorry though, pets, with the exception of service animals, are not allowed inside of the cabin or even on the porch. There are restrooms and showers available, and as a bonus, at no extra charge, you can even enjoy the lovely serenading from the makeshift aviary above. These little guys are so adorable. If you know what type of bird they are, would you please let me know in the comments below? Speaking of birds, the park has seen between 80 to 100 species over the last few years, including at last, the beautiful bald eagle. Still a rather rare sight here in California, but hopefully someday it will once again be common occurrence. There is also an abundance of oak trees throughout the campground to climb on or play on, if you're feeling brave, or just sit underneath and enjoy.
Careful. Reason number three, hiking. As it turns out, Spring Lake is also a favorite destination for energetic hikers, runners, bikers, and horseback riders. You will find nearly 10 miles of trails that include a 2-mile paved loop around the lake with views of forested hillsides. The multi-use trail accommodates walkers, runners, and cyclists and is ADA accessible. The trail elevation is mostly flat with a brief incline to the main dam. Unpaved trails such as a Fisherman's Trail, and the Horse Loop Trail intertwine with the paved trail, offering less traveled routes around the lake. Trails connect to the adjacent Trione-Annandale State Park, covering 5,000 acres of heavily wooded mountain trails on one side, and the city of Santa Rosa's Haworth Park with another gorgeous lake with rentals, including a long miniature train ride. And if you're feeling energetic, looking for a workout, we notice there's even a fitness course, although our preference was to climb oak trees with the grandkids. As we explored the park, we were fascinated with all the big rocks we encountered that fit in nicely with some of the games we made up. However, after returning home, our curiosity on these rocks remained. We were correct in suspecting that their origin was of the lava flow, and learned that many of these rocks were as a result of volcanic activity from the nearby Mount St. Helena. In fact, Mount St. Helena was named most recently in 1841 by a Russian survey party in Fort Ross. Now, I bet you didn't know that the reason the Spanish built the mission in Sonoma was to ensure that the Russians didn't keep moving closer to the Bay Area. But that's a story for another day. So Mount Hood formed over 3 to 4 million years ago. I lose track of the time over the years. Suffice it to say that it was the Pliocene era. The Sonoma volcanic activity accumulated in the valley basin 30 miles wide, and in some places the rocks took on that glassy look that turned into obsidian, a favorite cutting tool used by the locals along with perlite and vitrofire, whatever that is. Turns out that perlite and obsidian make good building materials, especially over the years being able to withstand inevitable fires. So the abundance of local materials were used by resourceful builders around the Santa Rosa area in the mid-1850s. But wait, there's more. For hundreds of years, many of these types of stones were used by the local Pomo and coastal Miwok tribes as charm stones. Make sure to subscribe, and we will be having future videos that discuss this in greater detail.
Reason number 4, the lagoon. During the summer months, Spring Lake Swimming Lagoon offers fun for the whole family, complete with a water park, sandy beach, beautiful lawns that are shaded under the redwood trees. A concession stand is also available, filled with some irresistible choices for both young and old. Admission to this park is $10 per person, and due to its popularity, reservations are highly recommended. Our favorite time of year, however, comes the week after the lagoon closes to families, and it opens up as the Bark Park.
Excitement was definitely in the air as Spring Lake's lagoon was open to these guys.
Our furry friends also get that chance to cool off and play with their buddies. Don't worry. After all the puppies have been unleashed and had their fun, the lagoon is drained, cleaned, and will be chlorinated and filtered before it's opened again the following season.
Reason number 5, boating. The lake has 72 acres available for boating and paddling, but be advised that like many smaller lakes, gas engines are not allowed on the reservoir. Yet you are sure to have a great time whether you bring your own watercraft, such as kayaks, or rent one of the many choices available at the park. All boaters and paddlers are required to wear flotation devices while on the lake, but try to avoid falling into since swimming is not allowed. Word is that drowning is frowned upon as well. There are two entrances to the park, so check out the Regional Park website for specific directions launching your own watercraft or renting one of theirs.
Sonoma County Parks has taken over the boat rental on the Big Lake, and that includes stand-up paddle boards, paddle boats, and kayaks, which are free for an hour if you get the season pass.
The lake surface is sometimes marked by azolla, an aquatic fern. Azolla growth varies due to weather conditions in the spring and summer. At first, we were taken back by the mysterious billions of water fern plant organisms that covered the water. But oddly, after we walked around the lake, presto changeo, they disappeared and apparently submerged to the bottom as the temperature changed. At least, I guess that's what happened. We understand that the azolla is rich in proteins, essential amino acids, vitamins, and minerals, but we passed on trying to put it in our dinner salad. Anyway, it took a while. It might look thick enough, and you can walk over the surface, but I wouldn't recommend it unless you have somebody with a camera, video camera, wants to record the whole event.
We have highlighted some of the many great aspects of this park, and I'm sure you can find some of your own reasons for visiting as well. The fishermen all seem to be having a great time, and the picnic benches looked inviting. There were parks to play on and wonderful works of arts and memorial to leave you in awe and be inspired. What are some of the reasons you like to visit your favorite regional parks? Be sure to tell us in the comments below. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you'd like to see more, be sure to subscribe and smash that bell. As always, thanks for watching, and
until we meet again, happy trails!
Woohoo!